these are jokes. Not meant to offend anyone. Don't take it seriously. Mutual fund investment are subject to market risk. Every occupation in this world has an occupational hazard. Yeah? Disaster can happen to you at work. The probability of something wrong happening to you at work is always greater than zero. If you are a driver, you might die in an accident. If you are a firefighter, you might get fired. If you are an IT guy, you might get fired. You know, disaster can happen. Why I'm telling you this is, you know, this amazing stand-up profession that we do in India also has its own occupational hazard. People get offended for jokes. India is a country with billion people. We come up with trillion ways to take offense. We don't give them, they just take and walk away. We will never see them thereafter. It's amazing, man. In every country, in other countries, whenever a comedian uploads a video, they'll just say these are jokes and move on with their life. But in India, when we upload a video, we have to clarify. These are jokes. Not meant to offend anyone. Don't take it seriously. Mutual fund investment are subject to market. All these things we have to do. Why I am telling you this? This happened to me, okay? Like, I made some jokes about one famous, you know, Telugu actor, you know. His fans got offended. You know, they somehow found my number and started calling me, messaging me. Thousands and thousands of messages at the same time. My WhatsApp was not expecting that much traffic. It has never seen so much greenery in its life. So many messages and calls. Till 9 o'clock in the night, it will be Indian numbers. After 9, it was US numbers. People were abusing me on shift basis. I was getting death threats across continents. I can't believe those guys were waiting for Earth to rotate, sun to rise in their horizon. Finally, they woke up, ah, bro, good morning, bro. What do you want, tea, coffee? No, I want some abuse. There is this guy in India, I want to abuse him. I guess these Indian guys, they gave knowledge transfer to all those US guys. Bro, look, bro. In IST, we took care. Now the time zones are changing, but we should not leave him, bro. Come on, bro. Keep him attacked all 24 hours. Come on, soldiers. This is Sparta. Dang, what I did. I made some jokes. And the calls were increasing. It was not increasing exponentially. It was increasing in terms of Fibonacci series. Like 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21. So many messages. All the messages were having the same abuses. No creativity whatsoever. Same abuse. And for some reason, even their names were same. Same abuse, same name. Varun Teja, Krishna Teja, Ravi Teja. What is this Teja? I am asked to suffer. I don't understand. So many messages. And my friends started taking advantage of the situation. They used to send messages in between. Manoj, you suck. Arun, I have saved your number. I can see it's you. Moreover, I'm in your house for some peace of mind, so please help me. I'll share some of the messages that I used to get, okay? Because why I alone should suffer? One guy sent me on my WhatsApp, you motherboard, you motherboard, you motherboard, some 100 times. I started wondering which part of my body looks like a motherboard. If so, what is the RAM? What is the hard disk? Does it have graphics card? I like playing games. But 2 minutes later, he sent, sorry, bro, actually, I wanted to send you Mother Chod, you Mother Chod, you Mother Chod. The beauty was, he asked sorry to me. Next day morning, he started sending me good morning messages. With life quotes like, life is a race, run it. Life is a game, play it. Day, your life is in confusion, fix it. Why are you behaving like Gautama Buddha just because you made a spelling mistake? The other guy, he sent me, you bloody bastard. I replied him, bro, this is not correct. And he started getting angry. Oh, now alone you will say this is not correct? Where were all these morals and values when you made fun of our actor? He's an amazing actor. How can you make fun of our actor? Bro, I mean the spelling of bastard is not correct. B-U-S-T-A-R-D is not going to offend me. At least bastard sounds like an abuse, right? Some of the messages were so irrelevant and so random. You are gay. How it is related here? That too with full confidence. You are gay. It was never like, are you gay with a question mark? You are gay with a full stop. I saw you coming out of the closet, you better agree. You have AIDS. I started wondering, who is this amazing doctor who conducted a distant online blood test on my blood to confirm that I have AIDS? I got this message on Facebook. I went and saw his profile. His occupation was not working, still studying. I think he is still studying about the causes of AIDS or something. And as if this stupidity was not enough, I had to deal with poor English and bad grammar. Right? I'm not telling my English is so great. My English is very average. My English is actually surprise level, not flabbergasted level. This is the window within which my language proficiency oscillates. But I am educated enough to understand that the words dear and dare are two different things. One guy wanted to ask me, how dare you talk like this? Instead, he sent me, how dare you? That guy went from threatening me to romancing me in 2 seconds. I did not expect that voltage drop in his intensity. Imagine someone is running towards you with a knife in their hand with the intention of killing you. How dare you talk like this? And they come near you and the knife changes into a rose. How dare you? See, here is a guy calling another guy dear. Now, who is gay? Not me, you be whatever you want. I am not what you think. No. No means no, get lost. But that moment when I said no to that guy, it was a very historic moment in my life because for the first time ever, I said no to someone. Otherwise, I have always been in the receiving end. Suddenly, tables are turning. Now I understand why women keep saying no to men most of the times. If you say no to someone, you feel like you have achieved something. It gives a feeling of accomplishment, right? You all should do this. And the most common message that I used to get from them was, you are ugly. I know. Acceptance is my defense mechanism. What is your new weapon? Bring it on. You are ugly. I know. Actually, nobody is beautiful. This is my theory. Nobody is beautiful. Your ugliness is delayed. It will happen. Wait for it. They know that I am ugly and they will make video calls. How stupid are you? How low is your IQ to understand that it will be my face that will pop up? And the common question I was asked was, have you ever seen your face in the mirror? Yeah, I did that once. After that, I lost motivation. It's not a good sight, you also don't see. And their collective motto was to get one response from me, right? They wanted one reply. So to get a reply from me, they used to send messages like, hey, reply. Hey, replay. Hey, say something. Hey, something say, something replay. I don't mind replying to those guys. But some of the questions they asked me were unanswerable. I don't even know how to answer those questions. Why are you speech? What should I reply to that? Sorry, bro. Next time I'll become poetry. I'll use rhyming words also, I promise. Why are you speech? Say sorry for our actor. I can feel sorry for your actor, for having shitty fans like this, but how can I say sorry for? But I thought, it makes sense to reply, right? Because I wanted to justify my stand. I wanted to reply to someone. So I opened WhatsApp. One guy was typing. I started typing. He saw me typing and he stopped. I also stopped. He started typing. I started typing. He stopped. I stopped. We were playing this game for a while. After some time, I got bored. Now I pressed the recording button. I sent a blank voice message for 5 seconds. Before he could open it, I deleted it. He got angry. Hey, what did you say? Say something. Something say. Say replay. Something replay. Now I found a new technique to annoy these people. So I thought I will implement this technique in other customers and enjoy their user experience. So I go to random groups where I got added. I send some random messages and I delete them before they could read it. Right? Once I ran out of messages and I sent this exact message. This message was deleted. I sent that and deleted that. He got angry. Hey, what did you send? This message was deleted. That I can see. What did you send? This message was deleted. I'm not blind. What did you send? This message. He got angry and he blocked me. He became the very own thing that he wanted to destroy. It was very bad. I couldn't handle all these things. So I thought I'll put a very long Facebook post explaining everything. And I wrote a very long post, 40, 50 lines I wrote. Right? Nobody read that post. Because in between I wrote things like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, Telling Lies No Papa. I wrote 40, 50 lines. In the end, I end the post like this. Please consider this post as my apology. I thought things will end there. People will calm down. But no. One guy came and commented on that post. I don't want apology. I want sorry. He was getting support from his friends. Yes, bro, I agree. Damn. What is this partnership that you are forming in being stupid? I don't understand. And stupidity is contagious. So I got affected. So I went and replied to all those posts. How dare you talk like this? I think these guys, this is how they function in real life also. Right? If at all they get married, bro, is this your spouse? No, this is my wife. My apologies. So I don't know what that word is. I'm sorry. So I put up a post and I deactivated all my profiles, right? Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, Instagram, Bumble, everything. I deactivated all my social media profiles. I thought there is no other way for them to contact me and abuse me. But to my surprise, one guy texted me on Google Pay. You guys use that payment app. Imagine how disappointed Sundar Pichai and his team of developers will feel. When they brainstormed and came up with that app, they thought they are going to change the online banking transaction world forever. But in India, people are using the same app to send motherfucker. Lavade Gopal. This is what me. One guy texted me on Google Pay. Hey, Chutia, what happened to your Instagram account? See, my question is, I was offline from everywhere. You somehow Sherlocked yourself and found me here. Scold here only, Noda. What is this special reservation quota that you're having for Instagram that you will scold? I think that guy thought he wanted to scold me bloody bitch and realized, oh, Google Pay does not have dog filter. It won't look realistic, I don't know. One guy asked me on Google Pay, hey, Chutia, what happened to your Instagram account? I replied, it's inactive just like your brain. He got angry and he started sending me money requests. I replied him with a scratch card. Better luck next time. Better luck next time with my money and your abuse. And the final line of action they wanted to take against me was they wanted to take legal action. But the problem is, this is India, right? Like, their Actors Association sent a formal letter to our Tamil Nadu Actors Association. That letter is the funniest thing I have ever read in my life. My name was wrong. M-O-N-O-J is not me. Monoj Prabhakar is not what my father named me. In that letter, they wanted to take action against me. They have written it like this. Your actor, Monoj, has abused our actor. Our actor is the greatest actor ever. He has been acting for 2 decades. No, he's the greatest actor. You have to take action against your actor. Hey, first of all, stop. I am not an actor. I will agree. Right? That is their problem. By calling me an actor, they have proved my point. Right? For them, anybody is an actor. Thank you so much, guys. That's the show. Thanks a lot for coming. Hope you guys had a fun time. Thank you. Thank you so much.